be honest, I never thought I'd actually get the chance to enter this event, but after working for the company that decided to let me borrow someone else's pass, I managed to pretty much enter CES 2019. So I'm gonna be checking out these robots, these cute little guys, and of course, I also want to talk about the future of technology and the direction we're heading and how it will be used and what kind of impact will it make in our world. All this will be explained from my point of view. There's a lot to cover here, so I'll bring up as many points as I can within this time frame. This is Land Rider 7th, aka LR7, Land here, walking around as I wander around these booths, taking a closer look at this new technology, wondering how this will be used one day. Maybe it'll be attached on a good number of drones that are already available or are yet to be released, shown here. But then, how long will it be until they will one day be used for nefarious reasons? Time and time again. Again, whenever something gets released to the public, only so it gets regulated afterwards. Not necessarily saying that it can be a bad thing. If anything, sometimes it's necessary to keep those from doing further harm. However, it can also get abused by the very lawmakers that try to suppress it for everyone else, while those in power decide to take advantage of it. But what do I know? I'm just some guy that's looking into this a little deeper than I normally should. There was a time where innovations like these were nothing more than something you hear straight out of a science fiction movie. One can only dream where one can have such a device or assistant in which they are able to do anything their owners ask them to do, like asking them how the weather is, or something as simple as delivering pizza, in which a drone will deliver it for you, replacing the need of a human knocking on your doorstep to receive the pizza. As much as this would have been a reality within our time period, one has to have a specialized license in order to operate a UAV, in which is very regulated and making even public flight impossible to achieve. Also, what about the robots, where everyone will have their own that will do anything for them? In order for mainstream adoption of owning a robot becomes widely available and a common commodity or even a necessity, the technology itself has to serve those particular needs, as well as social acceptance of a machine that can coexist among humans, in which is only a matter of time until this technology becomes openly available, not just to enthusiasts, but to the casual consumer alike. Also, how about the ability for them to think for themselves without human intervention or even anyone remotely controlling them? This is when artificial intelligence will eventually become a thing. Actually, it already is. Some websites have it. The video you're watching from also has it, which is commonly known as the algorithm. But we all know how that turned out for everyone using this platform. The point is that it is here to stay and it'll continue advancing to other fields of existence. Even most modern day cell phones have artificial intelligence included to some extent. So it's only a matter of time until you'll be having a full-fledged conversation to something you'd probably be following you aside, or would be wearing it on your body like a personal assistant that tags along. Also, there's been this trend of rentable scooters and bicycles alike that has been taking place in this current time. So all you need is an app and you'll be able to unlock these vehicles as if you're renting them. Something like this would be more of a niche, but who knows how far is that going to take off if it ever does become successful. It would be perfect for a place where it's overcrowded with cars and you need to get around town without traffic stopping you or slowing you down. Or, for whatever reason, they decided to make them self-driving. So, what are the odds on that becoming a thing? I can see that something like this can actually take place in Asian countries, since they're more likely to get a hold of this technology first before the Western world does. Like many other innovations before, especially Japan, in which most of these booths are from. And let's not forget China, which they are working on this social credit score system where it was meant to keep people in check. However, it can also be used to discriminate based on certain norms, while making it difficult to even land a job or even get accepted to certain stores, restaurants, and even airports, let alone getting a home. This could change the way people interact with each other, as well as their whole surroundings, especially when it is run by a regime by the government of China. If such a system really happens, imagine if it becomes implemented here. Well, it's going to be a very dystopian future we're heading towards. If more people were aware about their online privacy being violated by these corporations and government entities alike, and let's not forget any random person with malicious intent, could lead to major trust issues as well as an insecure internet with many more restrictions and major censorship taking place by laws and copyright claims in order to silence those with opposing opinions. Despite any of this taking place, there will always be ways around them. So there is no actual way to censor every single user on the internet or even real life, even if they want to try and eradicate any means necessary by re-education or indoctrinating them while they're young. Word will come around and soon they will know. Even that won't be enough for those who refuse to live in reality. Speaking of which, the next big thing that will take place since the internet and gaming would be virtual reality and augmented reality, where they would still see the real world but be able to see things that aren't physically there. Imagine being able to walk around and explore this world that can be created by anyone and controlled by no one, built on top of technology that basically already exists, yet it can allow you to expand to more possibilities. So whenever you visit a website, you're basically visiting either a building or another world, while your second home is a 3D desktop or home screen as your personal space, where you can enjoy your content or work in privacy, or have some people over to check out what you have, or combine the real world with the virtual world and they can both coexist as one mixed reality environment. In order for such a concept to be a reality, there has to be a collaborative project by multiple companies, each working on different divisions like gaming, Internet of Things, as well as other ventures related to using the internet and 3D game engines, and that it can be usable on a day-to-day basis. There will certainly be different applications and programs under a standard that all of them will be able to see the same thing, similar to how web browsers, no matter what brand or name they are, can see the same website no different than the other. Plus, cross-platform. In order for this concept to fully take effect, it sure helps a lot if it's open source. I'm sure there's room for improvements for such an idea to be considered. Maybe somebody out there is already developing it. I'd hate to see such an idea becoming locked down and restricted, and you can only be allowed to do certain things while everything else is off limits, or worse. This may sound a little far-fetched, but I do believe that smartphones will eventually become a thing of the past and will be replaced with telepathic technology in which, surprise, surprise, they actually exist. Now, tie it around with the Internet of Things and everything will be controlled using the power of your mind. You're also going to want to have some ad block for your mind to avoid those pesky ads entering your thoughts or even influencing you to have funny ideas, or worse. Someone will be able to invent a device where they can save an entire map of whatever thoughts, feelings, emotions, and memories you have and save it into a solid state hard drive that can be read later on. At this point, you're definitely gonna want to password protect your mind. Change can certainly be a challenge for most of us, even harder for those that refuse to adapt, especially when Moore's law is at full effect, where technology is advancing so rapidly that we can't even keep up with the next update that gets released. Maybe we might end up reaching technological singularity where our technology has a limit, but I'm not going to say that for certain. Someone's going to make some discoveries to make it even better and shrink components or create stronger ones. Perhaps at this point, space travel may even be a thing in order to find exotic materials in order to fulfill these technological breakthroughs that are yet to happen within our lifetimes. One can only imagine how the future would look like, and others would help build it. We'll just have to wait and see and find out for ourselves. In the meantime, we can enjoy our giant screen TVs, our smartphones, cameras, game consoles, cars, smart speakers, unless you're okay with your conversations being recorded without your consent and sent to a third party, is not that big of a deal for you. Or a good portion of your devices that are connected to the internet are being collected by a database somewhere that can be used against you one day. And let's not forget about the cooperation between government agencies and corporations going as far as using your DNA to track down who you're related to, as well as discriminating based on genetics, tied to your online accounts, bank accounts, and even medical accounts. The world may turn out like China if nothing is being done about it. As much as I like to record even more booths, but unfortunately, both my camera and my phone battery had died, so I wasn't able to get more footage as I'd like to. And even the company that I was investing into was there, but once again, I couldn't get that on film. Well, hopefully for next time, I'll just leave it from here and you guys can decide what you think. Major changes are coming, and a question for yourself is, will you be prepared to face these changes? Will they benefit you in any way, or will they break you down, resulting in losses? Talking about the good old days that you'll never get back. Till then, this is Landrider 7th. Logging out.
Oh, what I do? Oh, for the company I...
Subscribe to PewDiePie.